In this video, I'm going to introduce you to Markdown and talk about how to use and convert Markdown. But first, what is Markdown? Markdown is a lightweight formatting language designed to create text using a plain text editor. It was developed by John Gruber and Aaron Schwartz in 2004 with the goal of making it easy to read, write, and edit text. Markdown has since become widely adopted for its simplicity and versatility. Markdown is most often converted from and to HTML. And let me show you a sample of Markdown here in my text editor. And we're going to look at this more closely in a bit, but I want to show you the single hash designates an H1 heading in HTML. The double stars or asterisks around text will make it bold. And if you look down here, the double hash will make it an H2. You can keep going down the line. A triple hash will be an H3 and a quadruple hash will be an H4. I'm going to include a cheat sheet in the description so you can see all of the different ways you can format text with this markup language. Next, I'm going to show you how to convert Markdown to HTML. But first, if we haven't met yet, my name is Andy, and if you want to learn how to automate your business with make.com, then I want to invite you to the CoBuild Collective. It's an automation coaching community for entrepreneurs and freelancers. All right, let's head over to markdowntohtml.com. Right down here is that cheat sheet that I told you about that you can look at and the different ways to format text. Up here at the top of this page, I've found this site useful over and over again, and it's just something is my go-to when I need to convert Markdown to HTML or vice versa. So you can see over here in the left side, we have our sample Markdown. You can see the single hash here, and we have a heading here. If I look at the raw HTML, you can see that that single hash creates an H1. This double hash creates an H2. Let's put in the Markdown that we just looked at here, and you can see it converts it immediately. Here's the where is Markdown, and right here is our HTML. Does a really great job. Converting back and forth is really easy. Next, let's head over to make.com. If you're not familiar with make.com, it is a drag and drop, no code automation platform. It is the primary platform I use for myself and my clients. If you'd like to sign up for a free month of the core plan, click this link here. It's an affiliate link, and it will give you a free month of the core plan instead of a free month of the free plan. All right, so we're going to create just some basic scenarios here in Make. And the first one we're going to do is Markdown to HTML. And before I do that, I'm going to show you how I found this module. If you click here and type Markdown, you will see the options here. And there's really only two. HTML to Markdown and Markdown to HTML. So we have our Markdown here. I'm going to go Markdown to HTML. Normally you would map something in here from a previous module. Again, I'm just showing you how to convert it with these modules in Make, but these would go in a larger flow where you're dealing with Markdown. So here's the Markdown from my notepad. I'm going to copy that and we're going to paste it right in here and hit OK. So if we run this, and it's gonna say, wait a minute, this shouldn't be at the end. We're just gonna say run anyway. So now we have our HTML. I'm gonna copy that HTML and drop it into an HTML editor. So I've dropped the HTML on the right-hand side of my editor, and you can see here is my HTML. And this looks a lot like it did on our other site when we converted it. This works really well. So let's go the other way. Let's go from HTML to Markdown. I'm simply going to add a module here and click on my Markdown. It's up there at the top now because it's already in this scenario, so I don't have to search for it and find it. So I'm going to click that, and I'm going to go HTML to Markdown. So what I can do is I can map the HTML from our first step. We went from Markdown to HTML. Now I'm going to map the HTML, and we're going to go back to Markdown and hit OK. I'm going to save this because it's just a great practice to be in, and I'm going to hit Run. And again, it doesn't like that Markdown is at the end. We're going to say run anyway. It's okay. All right. So here's our first step. Again, is created HTML. And let's take a look at our output here. So this looks good. That looks good. Let's compare it to our original. Now I've got the original in the first tab and the new that we generated with Make in the second tab. And if I just flip across between the two of those, there is no difference in this Markdown. So that's how it works, is it turns this back into Markdown from the HTML, and it's a pretty reliable thing to do. If you have further questions about Markdown, put them in the comments below. I'll be happy to watch that and answer those for you. And if you want to learn more about make.com and watch some tutorials about how to automate with Make, check out this playlist, and you can subscribe to my channel over here. I thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.